You hit that long side. You hit that long side. If your shoulder is up, that will loosen your curve and really raise your hands. So short a range that we are here. Brush a little right shoulder in or shoulder forward. This is where we get into the first group. This exercise you always do. Keep those hands up on the day. Keep those hands up. Move up those hands. If you want your hands slightly to the inside, that keeps your horse's shoulder in. Keep your horse's shoulder in. That's it. Go straight ahead. Posting drop. If I say grab, you fix your seat and develop and keep them slow. Keep those hands up. You have to slightly move those hands. Get up in position. Watch your hands. That's a short one. Next. What's important about jumping and galloping is the upper body. Well, first is that upper body is inclined to the foot. This ducking that is so apparent down here, this jumping ahead is created by approaching fences too far behind the center of balance, the center of gravity. That's a jumper, circle, a jumper, when he gets there, jumps or throws himself over the left to the right side of the horse's neck.
Right turn, look over here, so that horse gets soft in that turn, and turn to bring the gentleman forward there. Don't sit back on him.
Left turn. Come back. Look at this first fence. Come on to this first fence.
Up. yesterday to have that gum being late because you were riding quite long. Your hands, or both sides, are in the same place. Separate them, lower, keep that contact. This necessitates a very elastic arm. And you have that up again. This one has it with it. You see how the contact is the same.